Welcome back to another episode of The Road Shows Me. And today I'm going to continue the series of running through the pros and cons of different overland sleep setups. So in the first video, I compared ground tents to sleeping inside your vehicle. In the second video, I compared rooftop tents to pop-up integrated roofs like I have. And now in this video, I'll run through the pros and cons of trailers or caravans, if you're from Australia, and how they can be advantageous and in what ways they are negative. And especially towards the end of the video, I'll go over why lots of people don't use them for global overlanding, and they're really not the most common choice. So if you've ever wondered about trailers for overlanding, stick around. I'm gonna get into all the details right now. So before we get into the details, I want to clarify what I'm talking about when I say a trailer or a caravan for overlanding. And what I mean is something that's purpose-built for off-road or rugged travel. So there's a ton of options out there that are more like RVs or just, you know, caravans. They're fine on paved roads, they're fine if you're staying in paid campgrounds. But the reality is, if you take them on rugged roads, if you drive the Pan American or around Africa, those type of vans, they're going to rattle to pieces in no time at all. And in fact, when you get down into Mexico and Belize, or when you get down into Senegal or as far as Mali in Africa, you find a ton of these things abandoned by people who've driven them down. They've only made it a few thousand miles and then they've literally fallen apart. So that's not what I'm talking about here. I think they're great for some kinds of camping, but for overlanding, for what I'm talking about, going really remote on rugged trails, that's not what I'm talking about. They have their place and other people can talk about them. And of course, there's a lot of different varieties. Some trailers have canvas sides that pop up, some you just throw a rooftop tent on top of. And I think they all have their own little pros and cons. But in this video, I'm going to talk more about the big picture and kind of the pros and cons that I think apply to all trailers, no matter which kind of variant they are. And at their most basic, we have the kind that my friend Eric here put together. So this is actually a military trailer, and he essentially threw a rooftop tent on it, threw a fridge in it, a bit of a kitchen setup, some lighting, and you know, it can carry all of his food and all of his gear. And in its most simple form, this is where its biggest advantage shines through, is that you just get more space so you can carry more stuff. This is the biggest advantage of an overland trailer. So because all of his camping or overlanding gear is inside of his trailer, that frees up all of the space inside of his vehicle. So more payload, more stuff, that's really nice to have. It also means the next biggest advantage is you're getting all of that weight and all of those modifications away from your vehicle. So in Eric's case, he has a really cool Jeep that he loves to take out on the trails, and he doesn't want to compromise that by adding the weight of a rooftop tent on the roof or a fridge inside of it or all of his clothes and food. So in this way, by putting it all in the trailer, it means that his Jeep is still really great to drive on the trails. And this is where a trailer really shines through. What he does is he takes it places, sets it up as a base camp, leaves it there, and during the day, he can take his Jeep out and go driving on trails. And so that is an enormous advantage. His camp remains set up, the tent is open, the fridge is staying cold, he's got solar panels and batteries built into his trailer. So it's like a self-contained little camping unit while he takes his Jeep out and has fun. And so that works really well if you have a vehicle that you want to drive on the trails. Works equally as well if you have a vehicle that you daily drive to work during the week, and so you don't want to modify it too much. You don't want to compromise your gas mileage with a rooftop tent. You don't want to have a fridge permanently mounted. All of those compromises to your vehicle, you don't have to do them. You can just leave your vehicle more or less stock, take it to work during the week, then on Friday night, you hitch up your trailer and you're ready to go overlanding, and the trailer is like this self-contained unit. So huge advantages right there, no doubt about it. as you get slightly bigger in the trailer world, you can see here my friends Jared and Jen, they actually shipped their vehicle to South Africa and they purchased this big Conqueror trailer. And this is made in South Africa, so no doubt about it, purpose made to be tough, to be durable. And this thing is literally a house. You know, you can get a model that has a shower, it has a hot water heater, it's got a huge big fridge freezer, it has plenty of room inside to stand up and walk around. You know, if it's pouring rain, you can be in there, change your clothes, has an enormous kitchen. Jen loves to cook, so they cooked really great food while they were in Africa. So this starts to be another advantage. If you step up in size to a bigger trailer, you really do get a house on wheels. So where my Jeep is very much a compromise, it's a smaller vehicle and my living space is quite cramped. If you're willing to tow a bigger trailer, you just wind up with more living space. And again, more space means you can bring more stuff as well. Jen's spice rack is about 5 times bigger than mine. You know, they carry flour so they can bake bread. All of these kinds of luxuries or enjoyments when you're on the road, they basically just get bigger. You can just have more of them so you can enjoy your time more. Other huge advantages to having a trailer. And I should say too, I'm gonna steal a bunch of photos from my friends Jared and Jen. On Instagram, they are The Pioneering Spirit. I'll put a link down in the description. You should definitely check it out. Scroll back through their Instagram and see their photos from Africa. They did an awesome trip. Another really good advantage of a trailer is that it just gives you more living space for more people. So, you know, my Jeep worked fine for 2 people, but without a back seat, it can't even accommodate 4. But if you had 4 people, you know, this isn't really big enough to sleep them all. That's again a huge advantage of a trailer. You could have a rooftop tent on your Jeep and some sort of sleep setup in your trailer. So then you can sleep 4, 6, maybe even 8 people if you have the right vehicle and the right trailer. So if you're a big family or if you're kind of 2 groups of people and you wanna have just more living space, that's where a trailer becomes a huge advantage. So yeah, I think trailers have a lot of advantages on paper. They seem really good, but there's no doubt about it, they have some disadvantages too, and I'll go over those now. First and foremost, I'm gonna say the biggest disadvantage is that you're just bringing more stuff. And nobody ever talks about this, but especially when you're on a longer term overlanding trip, everything you have with you becomes a burden. It becomes a burden to maintain it, to check that it's still working properly. You know, if it's electronic, you have to charge it. If it's something to do with suspension, you have to grease it. You have to check the tires, maybe carry spare tires. And so once you add a trailer behind your vehicle, you're just adding to your burden. You're adding to the amount of stuff you have to maintain. And that really does become a thing when it is day in and day out, you're driving it on the worst roads in the world. That's a lot of extra mental effort and burden to have to maintain all of that extra stuff. So while bringing more stuff brings you more comfort, it also is more burdensome and more of a maintenance kind of headache that you have to deal with. Of course, a big disadvantage also is price. So not only do you have to purchase the trailer, which depending on how fancy you get, they can actually cost more than my Jeep costs. That's one factor. But the other one is it's going to make your trip more expensive. So no matter what vehicle you drive, if you tow something, it is going to affect your gas mileage. So you will spend more on gas or diesel to actually undertake your trip. The next thing you have to think about, of course, you have to register that trailer and you have to insure that trailer. That adds up money-wise. If you decide to go international, you're going to have to ship the trailer as well as ship your vehicle. So where I was able to fit this in a 20-foot shipping container and shipping was about $2,000 to $3,000, if I had a trailer on the back, now I need a 40-foot shipping container, shipping's gonna be $4,000 to $6,000 to $8,000. So immediately then, your trip starts to be a lot more expensive. I said trailers are really great if you wanna leave them somewhere and have a base camp. And I think that works really well in developed countries. You know, theft isn't such a big issue and it's kind of common to have a group camping area where there'll be a lot of people. But when you're on a more long-term trip, it's kind of more like each and every day you're moving. Even if you're driving up to Alaska and back, you know, that's a lot of days on the move where like every evening you set up camp and then every morning you pack up and you go somewhere else. And with a trailer, you have to spend time getting it level. You have to spend time folding out all of the different doodads and whatever it has. And you kind of set up a really comfortable home. But then when you get up in the morning, you're going to have to pack all of that away again. So there's no doubt about it. You pack up time and you set up time. They just increase when you have a trailer, which I think is a downside. That again, shorter trips, maybe the trade-off is worth it. But once you're on the road for months or years, that starts to be a burden. Along that same vein, driving with a trailer no doubt is more difficult. The roads in Latin America are much narrower, and in Africa, it's really common you drive somewhere and then there's an official or there's some reason where they say, no, you have to go back, go around, you went the wrong way. It's kind of a bit of a power game that gets played sometimes. So I sometimes call it make it up driving when you're in other countries and you don't know where you're going. You do tons of U-turns, you do tons of reversing, you get stuck on narrow streets. It happens all the time, even just in my Jeep, and it makes my Jeep feel big. If I had been towing a trailer through all of that, it just increases, you know, kind of the stress or the burden while you're driving. And if you're a trailer person, maybe that's fine. But for me, it kind of is going to detract from the enjoyment and it's going to increase my stress levels. So it's not something that I'm super excited about. Of course, you have this trailer, you're going to have lots of stuff in it. No doubt it's going to weigh quite a bit. That is going to make it harder for you to drive places when you're getting remote and trying to go off-road. You know, there were plenty of places where I nearly got this stuck in the deep sand, but I was able to keep moving. Had I been towing a trailer that's a couple of thousand pounds, I'm pretty sure I would have got stuck. And in fact, I know my friends Jared and Jen did get stuck in places that I didn't get stuck. So a trailer is going to detract from where you can and can't go, or just make it more difficult. Of course, too, a trailer means you have two more wheels on the ground. That means you probably need to carry an extra spare tire. And while we're on that, if I did have a trailer, I would make certain that it runs the same wheels and tires as my tow vehicle so that they're interchangeable. But that means you're carrying more spares and you're gonna have more wear and tear. You have to deal with the wheel bearings on the trailer, maybe it has suspension. These things all get beat up a lot when you're on a longer trip and the trailer is just more that you have to maintain. So trailers certainly have some advantages and they certainly have some disadvantages. But I get asked all the time, what about for global overlanding? What about to drive the Pan American or to go around Africa like I did? And very, very few people do it. It is not common at all. And I think there are a bunch of reasons for that, being that it's more burdensome, being it can make border crossings more difficult. Some countries want you to have a temporary import permit for the tow vehicle and for the trailer, which gets annoying. If you're getting a carnet de passage, the legal document that I talked all about in this other video, sometimes it's kind of a gray area whether you need to get a separate one for the trailer and for the tow vehicle, which is going to increase costs and difficulty quite a lot. I think too, global overlanding is kind of more like you're on the move, so that whole setup and pack up thing every day becomes a bit of a burden. And also too, is for global overlanding, I personally like to wild camp as much as I can. And I did a lot of it in Africa. And so for me, sort of being smaller and more self-contained, it makes it easier just to sort of poke off a gravel road and find a little spot where you're out of sight and you can camp there. Whereas when you have a trailer, you're gonna have more difficulty finding a big enough area for the vehicle and the trailer. It has to be level, all of that. And by the time you've set up your whole system, it's not as easy for you to sort of pack up and move along if you need to, like if it turns out people come along and tell you you can't camp there or something along those lines. And so as that goes, I wild camped a lot while I was in Africa, whereas my friends Jared and Jen with their trailer, they didn't wild camp very much at all. It was really uncommon for them. And I think part of that was their comfort level, but also part of that is, you know, they had this big, enormous trailer and it just wasn't as easy for them. So the trailer for international overlanding, it's really not common. Not many people do it at all. And in fact, I met an Australian couple. They shipped their Land Cruiser and their big Australian camper trailer. They shipped it from Australia to South Africa. Purpose-built trailer, fantastic for the job. And by the time they got to Kenya, they were utterly sick of it. They just couldn't handle how annoying it was to drive with on the really bad roads, how much more attention they got from the police along the way, because now you're this sort of bigger vehicle, you are going to attract more attention, and the police are more likely to find a reason to invent a ticket or to come up with a reason why you have to give them money. They also were just annoyed with the amount of setup and pack up time. All of these reasons combined, when they got to Kenya, they spent a lot of money. They put their camper trailer in a shipping container and shipped it back to Australia, and actually bought a roof rack and a rooftop tent for their Land Cruiser, and they were going to do the rest of their trip like that. So as much as they had loved the trailer or caravan while they were in Australia, they found for Southern and Eastern Africa, it was more of a burden than a good thing, and they got rid of it and they went back to a self-contained vehicle. So for international overlanding, can it be done with a trailer? Yeah, absolutely. I'm sure people have gone all over the world, but it's probably less than 1% of people who do. And so you really want to think about, why is that? There's definitely a reason, and you know, it's kind of a combination of all of those factors and all of those negatives, is that most people prefer a self-contained vehicle rather than a tow vehicle and some sort of trailer. So I hope that's been helpful, and I hope it helps you understand why caravans or trailers might be good in some situations, but maybe they aren't ideal for driving really long distances and traveling through multiple countries or around an entire continent. So I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. You guys have more experience with caravans and trailers than I do. Please let me know down in the comments, how have they worked for you, and what are the reasons that you love them, or what are the things that you wish were different about them? So if this has been helpful, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to my channel. I put out new videos every Monday and Thursday, and it's my supporters on Patreon that are helping make that possible. So go over to Patreon, check out the perks that you get by supporting my channel and for helping to bring these videos to life. So thanks again to those guys, and until next time, stay safe out there. Maybe I'll bump into you on the road.